This is the biggest quarterback that NFL players fear, Jared Lorenzen. Standing at a staggering 6'4 and 300 pounds, Lorenzen is someone that even NFL players are afraid to get their hands on. I mean, he's tall enough to play in the NBA, yet big enough to plow over rugby players and probably become a heavyweight champ. But to top it all off, he's a quarterback for crying out loud. So pause your Madden game and witness the story of a player you thought couldn't exist outside of video games. There's truly no one like Jared Lorenzen. It all started nearly 40 years ago, on February 14th, 1981. Because even as a baby, Lorenzen was a giant. While most babies come out all cute and petite, Lorenzen weighed 25 pounds at birth. Nah, just joking. In actuality, he weighed in at 13.3 pounds at birth, which is still pretty huge. But Lorenzen didn't let his naturally large frame get in his way. Because during his high school days, Lorenzen was a letterman in not one, but three sports. Football, basketball, and baseball. So this man could honestly do it all. And with off-the-charts athleticism in multiple sports, you know it wouldn't take long for the college scouts to come knocking on the door. And when the scouts came knocking, Lorenzen quickly realized that he loved one sport more than the rest, football. So 5 games into his senior year, he took the next step and committed to the University of Kentucky. So now that all of his focus was centered on football, Lorenzen took his game to the next level at Kentucky. Even as a freshman, it was clear to the coaches that they had hit the jackpot. With no reservations about Lorenzen, he was locked in as their starter from day one, despite already ballooning to 260 pounds plus. However, it wasn't all smooth sailing for Lorenzen. You see, he had stumbled across a classic case of being at the wrong place at the wrong time, and there was nothing he could do about it. Because Hal Mumme, the coach who recruited him, left shortly after his arrival. But it's hard to blame Mumme for his decision, though. After all, when you lose a large chunk of your staff following an investigation into NCAA rules violations, it's easy to want to depart. So cueing coach number two, Guy Morris. Yet, this didn't last long either, because Morris became the head coach at Baylor University just 1 year later in a wild turn of events. Tough. Surely things can't get much worse. Third time's the charm, right? Well, not quite. Bring in Lorenzen's third and final college coach, Rich Brooks, who designed plays where Lorenzen lined up as a receiver instead of a quarterback. Damn, a 260 receiver? I know I'd be scared. But with obstacles flying left and right at Jared Lorenzen, it'd be safe to assume that Lorenzen never lived up to his true potential, right? Nah, wrong. As it turned out, my man thrived despite all the challenges. Not only did Lorenzen lead Kentucky to winning seasons, but he broke school records too. By the time his college career finished, Lorenzen had held the school's record in both passing yards and passing touchdowns. This dude is the true definition of a demigod. So after a successful college career, Lorenzen was ready to take his skills to the NFL. Unfortunately, that opportunity was up in the air. For the first time in his life, Lorenzen's weight was viewed as a hindrance. Teams doubted whether or not Lorenzen could succeed in the NFL because of it. It also didn't help that when Jared Lorenzen weighed in at the NFL Combine, his weight had increased to 288 pounds. And when the NFL draft rolled around, Lorenzen faced a rude awakening. His previous success didn't matter. Over 250 picks went by, and Jared Lorenzen wasn't one of them. What the hell? But just when all hope seemed lost, Lorenzen's phone finally rang, and it was the Giants calling. While the call wasn't what he had originally expected, it became clear that Lorenzen's dreams weren't lost. But if one thing was for certain, he was now back to square one, the Proving Grounds. So after making the best of his opportunity, Jared Lorenzen signed with the Giants as an undrafted free agent. But even with this glimmer of hope, Lorenzen faced an uphill battle, since it didn't help that the two quarterbacks ahead of him were a young Eli Manning and Tim Hasselbeck. So you might think he didn't have a chance. But fortunately, that chance would eventually come. After spending 2 years as the third-string quarterback behind Manning and Hasselbeck, Lorenzen finally got his opportunity in 2006. With a solid showing in the 2006 preseason, Lorenzen became Eli Manning's backup. While Manning remained healthy throughout the season, Lorenzen made his first NFL regular season appearance on December 30th, 2006, for a 3rd-and-1 situation. Unsurprisingly, Coughlin called a quarterback sneak, because who wouldn't want to use this tank of a man to plow over people? Luckily, my man came through, picking up the first down. And I don't blame him, because who would want to tackle this man? But Lorenzen stayed focused on his craft and retained the backup job for the second straight season in 2007. My man is dedicated. Unlike in 2006, Lorenzen actually got a chance to shine this time around. Because unlike the previous season, Tom Coughlin didn't have much of a choice. Late in the Giants' season opener against the Cowboys, their fans' worst fear came true. Eli Manning got injured. So without many other options, Jared Lorenzen was thrust into the spotlight in the fourth quarter. Sadly, this moment, years in the making, was underwhelming, because the Giants failed to earn a first down. And the following week, Lorenzen completed 3 out of his 5 passes for 21 yards. Although it wasn't a bad showing, Manning would return the next week and take back the reins at quarterback. Ultimately, Eli Manning never looked back and led the Giants to a Super Bowl victory that same season. What a moment for Eli Manning, Jared Lorenzen, and the Giants as a whole. Coming off a Super Bowl victory, what could be better? How about getting cut? Yeah, it's true. This became Lorenzen's final year with the Giants, and ultimately in the NFL. Plus, we have got to give my guy credit for dealing with Coughlin as long as he did. At times, Tom Coughlin can be a jerk, especially since he had strict weight guidelines for his players. For Lorenzen, he had to stay under 292 pounds during Friday weigh-ins. Initially, that seemed more than doable. However, for someone with a build like Jared Lorenzen, that proved to be a next to impossible task. So Lorenzen came up with a plan. Every Thursday, he would literally starve himself while spitting in a bottle to reduce water weight throughout the day. Dang, that's intense. But that's just the beginning, because on Friday mornings before the weigh-in, Lorenzen would wear 5 shirts, a hoodie, shorts, and sweatpants to burn off even more weight. Then, his final step was to bake in the sauna and practically run himself to death on the elliptical bike. So you might be thinking, all this effort just to stay under 292 pounds. So what did he do after he was released? The truth is, Lorenzen let go of his weight, but he still hadn't lost his burning passion for football. So this time, he entered the management side of the game. Jared Lorenzen became the general manager of the Northern Kentucky River Monsters of the Ultimate Indoor Football League. However, he found it incredibly difficult to find a good quarterback to run his team. And after struggling to find a quarterback, Lorenzen realized that he still wanted to play. So his next move was resigning as general manager, reliving his glory days to become the team's starting quarterback. Turns out, he could still ball, even at his new weight of over 310 pounds. In an impressive revival, Jared Lorenzen won the league's MVP award after throwing for 81 touchdowns. So it wasn't like he was a bad player. But unfortunately, after playing quarterback for a few more teams, Lorenzen suffered a career-ending fibula injury in 2013. Without football in his life, Lorenzen continued to struggle with his weight, as he eventually weighed over 500 pounds before passing away in 2019 at the young age of 38. A life taken too early, but a memorable one indeed.